Does promoting your business make you want to scream? Do you spend thousands of dollars on advertising your business only to see little or no results from it? Well, you need to know that it does not have to be that way. I'm Priya Florence Shah, and today I will be covering the basics of blogging and how you can use it to brand yourself and your business online. Promoting yourself and your business does not have to be a frustrating waste of time and resources. Let me give you a little background on why this is so. The world has changed today, with readers looking to online sources for news and information. Print media is dying and online sources like blogs are becoming the preferred source of information. Now, why is this so important for you to understand? Because when you control the news, you can use it to grow your brand. Publishing a blog instantly makes you a publisher. You become the newsmaker. Today, the newsmakers are not the big media publishers. They are the independent publishers, the writers, the authors, bloggers, experts who take the time and trouble to get their voice out online. When you publish a blog, you become the go-to person in your industry, and you're the one who gets quoted in the media and other news sources. This is the primary reason why a blog may be just the tool you need if you're looking to brand your business online. Now, for those who are new to blogging, let me explain a little bit about what a blog is. It is a chronological series of entries of posts, with the last dated post first. These posts can be in text, audio, video or image format. Now, as a business owner, your blog becomes your medium to connect with your audience on a more personal level and in a more consistent way than placing one-time ads. Your blog increases awareness of your company and it helps you grow your customer base and also attracts partnership and business opportunities. Another way that businesses can benefit from having a blog is that you can update your website yourself. You don't have to call your designer to do it. You can add new posts, images, videos, and have complete control over your website. Another benefit of publishing a blog is that it helps you get branded as the expert in your industry. Because a business blog usually focuses on your expertise, it gives you instant expert status. It provides you with a platform to showcase your knowledge. People are more likely to buy products or services from those they think of as experts. Blogs are also great tools for the media to get to know you. They become aware of you, they contact you. When reporters read your blog, they will contact you to get quotes or often will directly pick up quotes from your blogs and use them in their articles. Just ensure that you allow quotes from your blog to be used with attribution and you offer contact information on your blog so that they can contact you directly should they need to. Now, blogs also help you connect with a global audience. So remember that every time you craft your posts, before you write, consider the sensibilities of other cultures, especially if you want to attract business from other countries. Most businesses would love to have a number of fans or followers who look forward eagerly to their posts. Now, if you are a good writer or if you have a good writer, you can build a thriving community on your blog. Invite people to comment. Make sure that your blog is shareable on social media. Blogs are also one of the best tools you can use to attract organic search engine traffic. With every blog post you publish, you can create optimized content that is attractive to both search engines and readers. Now, because we use good SEO practices in our blogs, around 70% of our blog traffic comes from search engines. If you want to drive traffic to your website, just by publishing a blog on your own website or linking to your website from your blog, you can drive more traffic so that your readers can access your services and products on your website. Blogs are also a great place to convert readers to subscribers. You can offer a free report or a coupon for subscribers, and you can capture leads from your blog. You can also advertise promotions and special offers on your blog. According to these statistics from HubSpot, leads from blogs cost the least as compared to those from other social media and marketing channels. Now, one of the things I get asked frequently is, why do I need a blog when I have Facebook, Twitter and LinkedIn accounts? Now, I wrote about this on my blog a little while ago, but here are some reasons why your blog should be the hub or the center of your online presence. First of all, having your own blog and mailing list of subscribers is a way to reduce the risk of having your social profile deleted, because you can then email your subscribers to join up anytime you have to start fresh with a new account or on a new social network. Now, a social network may be here today and gone tomorrow, just like Friendster and Orkut, which hardly anyone uses nowadays. But a blog allows you to conduct your business regardless of the internet's ever-changing mix of networks and websites. Your blog is your independent and direct line to your subscribers, and anytime you want to connect with them, you just have to post an update. Having the blog is like being the host at your own party. You're the star. You decide the theme and the conversation, and everyone drops in to read your post and comment on it. Unlike social profiles, a blog is also easy to customize to your own personal preferences. Few people are likely to link to your status update on Facebook, but many more are likely to link to an actual post on your blog or retweet your blog post on Twitter. Now, the lifetime of a social network post in real-time search results is very short, but your blog post could get a top ranking in Google and send you traffic and visitors for years to come. So now that you know why you need a blog, how do you set up a blog? The reason I don't recommend you use free blog providers like Blogspot to host your business blog is because it not only looks cheap and unprofessional, but your blog could get deleted anytime if you violate their terms, and that includes promotion. A free blog provider should be used only for a personal blog, not for a business blog. So which blogging software should you use? Now, I recommend that you set up the free WordPress software on your own domain with paid hosting. It costs very little to set up. The basic costs include just your domain and hosting. Now, WordPress is open source software. That means it's free, it's easy to set up and install, and it comes with a number of free plugins and themes, so that you can customize and design your blog by yourself. There are literally thousands of developers working to create free widgets and plugins and add-ons for WordPress. Now, these widgets and plugins allow you to cater to just about every feature you want to add on your blog, from SEO and tracking visitors to social bookmarking, emailing visitors, all the way to full-fledged membership sites. If you need a fully customized WordPress template or a theme, you can buy one or have it designed by a professional. Okay, so now that you know you have your blog up and running, what do you post on it? Here are some tips for creating content for your blog. The most important thing to remember is that your content must be unique, not copied from another blog or website. You can publish articles from sites like eZine Articles, which offer free for reprint articles, but unique content is the mantra if you want to attract high traffic numbers and engage your audience. Other ways of creating content are inviting guest bloggers to write for you. You can also outsource your blog writing to other writers. You can also save time and effort by rewriting what is known as private label rights content, which is content that you purchase for the sole purpose of customizing to your own writing style and niche. Just Google the term PLR along with your keyword to find content that is targeted to your niche. Another tip for creating content is to interview other experts in your industry and feature the experts on your blog. Not only will that help you build better relationships with your peers, but they will promote the interview to their own networks and give you free publicity in the bargain. Okay, now that you have your content, how do you go about posting it? Now, here are some steps that I follow to get the maximum leverage from my content. The first one is to optimize your content for keywords. Before you craft your posts, use the free Google keyword search tool to find appropriate keywords that your readers are already typing into Google. When you optimize your blog post using these very keywords, you will get better search rankings and more traffic from search engines. You must also use tags and categories to label your blog post appropriately. For tags, I recommend using the exact keywords or phrases you found using Google AdWords in your tags, as they will be picked up and displayed directly as a search result. You can use multiple words in your tags, that's no problem. With WordPress, you can also schedule posts to go out on a specific day at a specific time, especially if you want to make an announcement or just want to have a regular day to post to your blog, or if you're going on holiday and want to continue your posting. Now, if you don't enjoy writing, you could sit down at your computer and record a quick audio or video message, not more than a few minutes in length, and then post that instead of a text post. In fact, I highly recommend video posts because they get the highest engagement from readers. Now I'd like to talk about some blogging best practices because I see so many people doing this wrong. One of the most important things is to make your posts interesting and conversational. Stick to one topic per post. Don't ramble, because the biggest sin you can commit is to bore your readers. Make your headlines and copy interesting to your readers. Make them want to click on your headlines. Post your blog regularly so that both readers and search engines have a reason to visit your blog more often. At least once or twice a week is recommended. Now, because you're connecting with other people online, you need to keep in mind some do's and don'ts of blog etiquette. First of all, never cut and paste content on your blog without quoting and linking back to the original author. Always give credit where credit is due. If you borrow information or even a good idea from someone, give them the credit for it. Thank people for commenting on your blog and don't attack people who disagree with you. If you don't want negative comments on your blog, just delete them. Avoid getting into an argument or flame war with your commenters. Make your posts easy to read. Pay attention to general grammar and spelling rules. Participate and comment on other blogs. And watch your language. Swear words are rarely appropriate, especially on a business blog. Now be as professional as you are in real life and remember that whatever you write is available for everyone to read. Treat people with respect professionally and personally and your blog will be respected as well. Okay, now that you have your first posts up and running, how do you make sure people find them and read them? One of the things I love about blogs is that they are magnets for search engine traffic. But you also need to promote your blog posts if you want them to get the maximum mileage possible. Here are some ways that you can promote your blog. The first one is you can create short articles from your blog posts and submit them to article directories. This allows other people to reprint your posts and helps you build links back to your blog. Also, make it easy for readers to share your content on sites like Facebook, Twitter, Dig, StumbleUpon, Google, Pinterest and Delicious, because you can easily add widgets to WordPress that make it possible for people to share your posts with others. Now, guest blogging. Guest blogging is when you contribute a guest post to someone else's blog, preferably someone who targets a similar audience and has many more readers than you. Now, at the end of the post, you can add a link inviting them to subscribe to your blog. You can post useful and insightful comments on other blogs which relate to your industry where your potential readers might hang out. How do you create a blog community? The number one tool I recommend is email. Email is still the number one choice of many people who want to receive news and information. You must capture subscribers and send out regular email updates, and you'll get a lot of repeat visitors and traffic from email. Another thing you can do to capture subscribers is to write a special report for your blog subscribers and offer it as an incentive for them to subscribe to your blog. Another thing you must do is to build your fans on Facebook, Twitter and other social media networks. If you use a lot of images on your blog, also use Pinterest and Instagram to build your communities. Remember to engage your fans and followers by responding to them. Respond to their comments. Respond to each and every comment on your blog in the beginning. And make sure that you have a good system in place to catch and delete spam comments. Now here are some of the blogs that we publish for our own company and for our clients. This is one of our most popular blogs on topics of parenting. Even though I publish to it less often now, it gets around 20,000 page views a month. Now, this blog is a passion of mine to help career and business women in India achieve their potential. We are building a list of regular subscribers on it and also have a Facebook community of around 15,000 fans where we share content related to women from our blog and other news sources related to women's issues. Now this blog we published for the Indian arm of the international property consultant Jones Lang LaSalle. It was started for the express purpose of reaching out to the media and increasing their media coverage. And it has worked so well that most real estate journalists now follow it and often pick up content directly from the blog to quote people from the company. This blog was started recently for an award-winning Pune developer called Amit Enterprises, whose brand ambassador, as you can see, is Sachin Tendulkar. We write about the developer's recent achievements and initiatives on the blog, and we are reaching out to the media through it. So these are a number of ways that you can reach out to your audience through your blog. If you want to learn more, visit howtoblog.me and subscribe to our How to Blog 101 email course, where you'll receive 20 lessons that will show you how to create, publish and promote your business blog. And if you want to get in touch with me directly for our business blogging solutions, you can visit blogbrands.com, or you can contact me at priya@blogbrands.com.